Hello friends, today we'll study pointers in C. These are the contents of today's session. Introduction to pointers, introduction to the operators and the star, and use of the pointers in C program. Objective of today's session is, at the end of this session, you will be able to understand the meaning of operators like ampersand operator and the star operator. You will be able to explain the concept of pointers, as well as you will be able to make efficient use of pointers in C programs. Now let's see the introduction of pointers. Now here one integer type of variable I is declared, which is assigned with a value 3. This declaration tells C compiler to reserve space in memory to hold the integer value, associate the name I with this memory location, as well as to store the value 3 at this location. This diagram explains the same thing. I is a variable name or a location name. 3 is value stored at the location, and 65524 is a location number or the address location where the value is stored. Now let's see what do you mean by ampersand operator and a star operator. One simple program is given where the same thing I is declared with value 3 and 3 printf statements are used over here. First one who prints the address of I, second will print the value of I, and third will print the value of I in some different way. This is nothing but the heart of pointer which we are going to study right now. Now let's see the output of a program where the address of I first printf statement will display the location of variable I. Second, value of I will display the value available or associated with the variable I. And third, again, it displays the value of I with different representation, that is something with the operator, star operator and ampersand operator. It displays the same thing. Now before going to execution of this program, let's see how to pronounce these both the operators. This is nothing but the address of operator. Ampersand operator is pronounced as address of operator, and star operator is pronounced as value at the address operator. Now let's see the execution of this same program with the IDE. Now here I is a variable declared with value 3. Value of I we can define or declare or print with the help of printf statement. I am going to write down one more printf statement which will display the address of I. Address of I is percent u identifier is used, and ampersand operator is used to display the address of I. Now let's see the output of this program. Let's execute the code. Here it is displaying the value of I and the address of I. Now let's update something is like address of I and the value available with the address of I. Now let's check the output by again executing a code. And now here no any warning is available and giving the output like value of I is equal to 3, and here we'll make change, that is again value of I but with different symbols is giving the output value of I is again 3. What do you mean by this statement or this declaration? Now let's go back to our PPTs where this star symbol is pronounced as value at the address, and that's why value available at the address location 65524 is nothing but 3. That's why it is giving the output value of I is equal to 3. Now let's move forward with the different concept. Now here again one statement is given where J is equal to ampersand of I or address of I. Now here we can see that the address of I we are going to assign to variable J. But now if we are going to store the address of one variable into another variable, this variable will not be any ordinary variable. This variable is somehow special variable who can store the address. Here the same thing is explained. Remember that J is not any ordinary integer type variable. It is a variable that contains the address of another variable. Therefore, the J is declared as integer value at the address J, because this pointer is nothing but who stores the address of another variable. This diagram will explain this concept very clearly, where the J is a pointer type variable which is declared over here and which is holding the address of another variable, that is I. So that's why J is pointing to I, and that's why J is holding the address of I. This is all about the ampersand and a star operator, which are heart of a pointers concept in C. Now let's move forward for facts about pointers in C. Data type of a pointer variable and an ordinary variable whose address to be stored in pointer variable should match. Now let's see the previous example where I was integer type variable which was declared in previous program itself. One more J variable is declared over here, which is a pointer type variable and which is holding the address of another variable. That another variable is nothing but I variable. Now we need to keep in mind where the data type of a pointer type variable J, that is integer, and whose address we are going to store in a pointer type variable, its data type should match. The same is explained over here. Data type of a pointer variable and an ordinary variable whose address to be stored in pointer variable should match. I'd like to explain the same thing with the example. Now let's make some changes over here. Like suppose I am declaring a pointer type variable J of data type character, where now let's add one more statement is like J is holding the address of I. Okay, now here try to display the content of I, that is value available at the address J. Now let's check whether the answer or output is correct or not. Let's execute this code and let's check what is the error or a warning. Assignment from incompatible pointer type. It means the assignment from integer type variable to character type variable is incompatible. Where we are trying to assign the address of I whose data type is integer into a pointer type variable whose data type is character. It's not allowed. So now we are making change is like both the pointer type variable who is holding the address of another ordinary type variable, the data type of both the variable should match, where this is integer and this the pointer type variable is also of type integer. Now let's check the output again by executing a code. Now there is no any error and it is giving the correct output like value of j is equal to 3. Now let's go back to our program where I am repeating again the statement like data type of a pointer variable and an ordinary variable whose address to be stored in pointer variable should match. Other way around, we can say that the data type of pointer variable and ordinary variable should match. Now, these different concepts regarding pointer, that is single pointer, double pointer, pointer to pointer, array of pointers, pointer to arrays, functions and pointers, all these concepts we are going to study in our next session. Thank you.